Welcome back to my class. Today topic I am going to explain statistic chapter to draw Vogel graph. There are two types of Vogel graph. One is less than type, another one is more than type. Today I am going to explain how to draw for less than type Vogel. So here, let me read the question once. The following distribution gives the daily income of the 50 workers. Convert the distribution to a less than type cumulative frequency distribution and draw its Vogel. So here, this is very important question. You will be getting 3 mark guaranteed question in your board paper. So first column is nothing but the class interval, and the second column is the frequency. These are the data given in your question. So first thing, consider one more column, that is nothing but the cumulative frequency less than 10. So here, there are two points you should remember. For less than Vogel graph, you should consider the upper limit. For if it is more than Vogel graph, you should consider the lower limit. Is it clear? So now I should consider the lower, for less than 10, what limit I should consider? Upper limit. So here less than 120. Less than 120, then less than 140, less than 160, less than 180, yeah, less than 200. So less than 120, how many frequency that? That means how many numbers of workers are there? 1. So this is the second point you should remember. For less than Vogel graph, you should start the cumulative frequency from writing from the up to down. Is it clear? If it is more than Vogel graph, you should start from down to up. These are the two important points you should remember to write the values. Is it clear? First one is, for less than type Vogel graph, you should take the upper limit. If it is more than Vogel graph, you should consider the lower limit. Here you will be writing more than 100, more than 120, like that for more than 10. Is it clear? Now, 12, first value is 12, next, 12 plus 14 is nothing but 26, 26 plus 8, 34, 34 plus 6, 40, 40 plus 10 is nothing but 50. So, the total number of worker, n value is nothing but, n is equal to 50. So the point to plot on the graph. So points to plot in the graph of 120, 12, then 140, 26, 160, 34, 180, 40, 200, 50. So these are the points to be plotted in the graph. So here I have taken x axis is nothing but the upper limit and y axis is nothing but the lower limit. So according to the number we should plot the points. So I have taken 100, 120, 140 in the x axis and 10, 20, 30 in the y axis. Now first value 120, 12. So 120 is in the x axis and 12 in the y axis. So 12 will come after 10, the second line. The second line will be the 12. So these two lines will come and join here. So here we should mark 120, 12. Next 140, 26. 140 is in the x axis and 26 is in the y axis. So it will come here. See, these two lines will come and join here. That is 140, 26. Next, 160, 34. 160 is here. 34, 30, 34. The fourth line of the y axis. 160, 34. Next, 180, 40. 180 is here, 40 here.
lies here. 180, 40.
Next, 200, 50. 200 in the x axis and 50 in the y axis.
So these two lines will come and join here. 200, 50.
So we should join these points in the free hand. Just
with the free hand, join the line.
So this is the less than leg okay graph. Is it clear, children? Suppose in question if it is given only these two columns, they didn't give the class interval. They have given less than 120, the value is 12. Less than 140, 26. So directly plot the point. That is, we should consider this as x axis, this x coordinate, and this is as y coordinate. Directly plot the point on the graph. Is it clear, children?